الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين الله سبحانه وتعالى stated in his book وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا What the Prophet of Allah gives you, the take, act upon it. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid you, stay away from it. My khutbah today under the title of is not sunnah. Is not sunnah. Or it is not the sunnah. As we see, things goes up and down. People comes and goes. Condition of the people and the people themselves, nothing remains forever. But the deen of Allah is the most important thing. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed and sealed all revelation with the Quran and the authentic sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is what have to remain. Teacher, husband, wife, house, car, position, this goes and comes. But when your deen go or disappear or become a foreigner, this is a serious calamity. And we should stand for making sure the deen of Allah and the book of Allah and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the understanding of the Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, always remain. Me and you, we can go, other people will come. But the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it have to remain for those who come after us and those who come after them and continue until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring about his command. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that Islam bada'a ghariban wa sayaudu kama bada'a ghariban fatuba lil ghuraba. Aw kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet of Allah said Islam start as a stranger. People not acquainted with it. People do not know what is tawheed, what's right, what is halal, what is haram, what is right, what's wrong. When it start with a stranger. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, and this deen, the teaching, the message, it will come time to turn again to the same stage of being a stranger. So the Prophet is saying, blessed be those who are the strangers. The strangers, those who hold fast to this deen, and the correct teaching, and the proper tafsir, and the proper explanation and the correct understanding. They don't add or delete. They are not about bid'ah. They don't understand their deen by majority or culture or a country. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had made dua for those people who remain holding to the book of Allah and the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the same understanding of the Sahaba. You could not come with something new today, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us, فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ دَلَالَةٍ وَكُلَّ دَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. You want to be among the strangers? You want to be among those who are blessed by Allah, the people of Jannah? As the Prophet saying, Tuba, who? He didn't say for the Arab. He didn't say for a color of people or a country. But he said, blessed, we are the strangers. That means those people who will hold fast to the deen of Allah with the proper understanding. The haram could not be yesterday haram, and when we have a new leader or a new imam, or a new executive or a new board, the haram became halal. People could not change the laws of Allah. We are not talking about emergency or time of necessity. No, we talking about if everything remains the same, there is no exception, you're going to have to remain. Believe the same belief. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. This it. كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله. Same way. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم been ordered to believe. And the same thing the Sahaba also have been commanded to believe. And the belief and the practice. The belief and teaching. Holding to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي عضوا عليها بالنواجذ وإياكم ومحدثات الأمور. Hold fast to my sunnah, my teaching. Not his sunnah only in words, and we give him a different tafsir. Hold fast to my sunnah. And the practice of my companions, especially the Khulafa al-Rashideen, the four guided ones. Hold to it fast with your hind teeth and be careful from anything to be introduced to this deed. My brothers and sisters, I choose my khutbah about is not sunnah or is not from the sunnah today, because there is common things that we do it sometimes. We don't know we got it from our country, from our culture, or you made it up, or whatever it is. But we need to correct things here. We need at least that you get to know what you're doing is not proper. Now, I don't want to come somebody after Jum'ah and say, brother, so because it's sunnah. You try to tell me if I didn't do this sunnah, I'm a kafir, I'm going to hellfire. But what I'm going to tell you, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. Whosoever object to my sunnah, whosoever is not in agreement and aligned with my sunnah, is not from my followers. If you want to be delayed in the day of judgment, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala settle your case, this is between you and Allah. All what I'm telling you need to know, same way you know your right hand from your left hand, so you can eat with the right hand. Although the khutbah is not about eating and sleeping and walking, because there is sunnah in everything, even in the khutbah. And the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he used to raise his voice, his face change, كأنما منذر من جيش, as if he warning the army. Yes, this deen is serious. When you talk to the people in khutbah, this is something very important. You're warning people. You're waking up people. So we have to understand. I'm here only to underline certain things and tell you it's not the sunnah. Let's start, because we don't have too much time. And inshallah, for those who would like to know more and details, you can make some effort and come for Salat al-Maghrib. We can sit for about half an hour, inshallah, talk more in details. Number one, I try to observe things in our locality or our mosque, not in general, because it's too much to talk about it. We'll be talking until tomorrow. Greeting one another. What's our greeting? Good morning? You know what's the greeting. So when you're saying good morning to somebody, and he didn't start with the salam, I'm saying this is not the sunnah. What about greeting and saying assalamu alaikum, and one hug, two hugs, three hugs? You come back for Salat al-Asr, assalamu alaikum aki, and one hug, two hugs, three hugs. Come back again in Maghrib, one, two, three hugs. This is not the sunnah. Brother, I say assalamu alaikum, but I'm giving my brother, I'm giving him some love. I say it's not the sunnah. They said, simple like this. But this what we've been practicing since we took Shahada, brother. This is not my business. I'm here to convey to you is not the Sunnah. The Sahaba asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of us, يلقى أخا أينحني له؟ قال لا. قال أيأخذ؟ أيحتضنه؟ ويقبله؟ قال لا. قال أيأخذ بيده؟ ويصافحه؟ قال نعم. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم been questioned by the Sahaba. One of us see his Muslim brother. Should he bow down for him? He said no. He said, should he hug him and kiss him? He said, no. So don't try to give me some philosophy, brother, I'm giving my brother some love. I love him for the sake of Allah. It's good. You saw him in the morning, you saw him yesterday, you saw him in the dhuhr. Hug, 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 hug. And it has to be 3 hugs. Why? From where he got it? He said, should he take him and give him a hug and kiss him? He said, no. He said, should he take his hand and shake hand? He said, yes. So this is the sunnah. Enter in the mosque and not praying 2 rak'at is not the sunnah. Doesn't matter what time you enter. You be different from the sunnah. This between you and Allah. Don't ask me, am I going to get the hellfire because I did not pray 2 rak'at? Don't ask me this question. No, you are not going. Why? Because there is exception. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about the obligatory prayer. قال علي غيرها قال لا إلا أن تطوع. Yes, I know. Because from the sunnah, there is sunnah which is sunnah and sunnah which is a must. You have to understand. Because the sunnah is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But some sunnah is optional and some sunnah is obligatory. And I'm sure that all of us concerned about loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Love is not only a talk, it's an action. So when you enter the mosque, doesn't matter what time, even if the imam giving the khutbah. Brother, but my school of thought and imam so-and-so. Brother, I'm telling you, the Prophet, you're telling me imam so-and-so. Which one receives the revelation? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or Imam so-and-so? The Prophet in Yawm al-Jum'ah, Imam came and sit down, he said, Sallaita, did you pray 2 rak'at? He said, no. He said, kum fasalli. Here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking the Sahabi when he entered, did you perform 2 rak'at? He said, no. He said, get up and make 2 rak'at. And he was given the khutbah. So there is no talk for any Imam after that. Statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Brother, I'm going to pay for it. Pay for what, brother? I'm going to buy some tapes and I'm going to put it in the rug. You understand? Because the brothers, they are not lining up correct. You think you know better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? You don't think the Prophet know how to draw a line? It's so easy for them to draw a line. He used to have a stake with him sometimes. Okay, as you have dirty ground, you can make a line straight and say, stand on the line. But some Muslims are so lazy. A non-Muslim can straighten the line better than Muslims. If you don't believe me, go to Fort Jackson in the morning, 5-6 o'clock in the morning, and see about 500 soldiers. As soon as the commander or the leader say, give the order, in less than 10 seconds, they straight, like alif, straight like this. Muslims who've been making salah every day could not straighten the line until somebody going to put them a line. What do you need a line? Why the Prophet was doing it? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to always take the easy way. So the easy way, the Prophet did it. And the Prophet know about drawing a line. So drawing a line, okay, is not the sunnah in your rug. And the calamities that happen nowadays, they try to sell you a new rug. And each rug has a design of a prayer rug, which exactly everybody, what I notice this, in many Islamic centers, everybody want to stand on the drawing area and between him and the other brother is a distance of one hand span. The Imam leading the Musallin after Salah in Dhikr or in Dua. You want to say, oh Allah, guide my wife. I want to say, oh Allah, heal my son. Why does the Imam have to lead me in Dua? Forget about why is not why. Did the Prophet do this? Why Imam supposed to be example for the community, teaching them bid'ah by his action? Every Salah. Everybody waiting until the Imam will raise and everybody say, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Your need is different from the Imam's need. But everybody, this collective dua after every Salah. It's not the Sunnah. It's not from the Sunnah. Women praying in a different area while there is enough room in the main Musalla. Neither it is the Sunnah to have a partition between a man and a woman in the mosque. So as long as there is enough room in the main Musalla, women supposed to pray behind men. This is the Sunnah. Other than this is not the Sunnah. It's not from the Sunnah that women remain seated in the Musalla after the Imam Taslim out. If it's no class, no khatira, no anything like this, they're supposed to leave, not to carry conversation there. So it is the Sunnah for women to pray in the Musalla, and it's not the Sunnah for them that they have to have a partition. And it's not the Sunnah for them to remain sitting there in the main Musalla after the Imam Taslim out. Neither it is the Sunnah for men to leave until the Imam leaves, and the Imam leaves, now the people can leave. It's not the Sunnah that Muslims will be speaking and talking in the Musalla while people are reading Quran or making Sunnah, disturbing them, even with Quran. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying in the meaning, لا يجهر بعضكم على بعض بالقراءة. Don't disturb each other in the Salah, in the mosque, even with Quran. We have to understand you're sitting in a Musalla, doesn't matter if there is a prayer or not. After Salah, Assalamu alaikum Aki, Assalamu alaikum, and everybody's talking as if you in the flea market. You have to respect the place. Especially if somebody's still making dhikr or reading Quran. So we, alhamdulillah, we have a reception area and we have a big lot outside. You can take your conversation outside. It's not from the Sunnah that always making the Sunnah prayer in the mosque. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid us and saying, لَا تَجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ مَقَابِرًا. That make some of this Sunnah or most of the Sunnah prayer, like Shafa and Watr after Aisha, make it in your house. So it can be blessings in your house. The best place to pray your obligatory in the mosque. And the best, the most rewarded Salah is what you pray in your house. Optional prayer. It's not the Sunnah that when the Imam saying, قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة, everybody or somebody say, أقامه الله أدمه. They have a dhikr for everything. From where you got this? The brother was strong. I'm making, I say, but did the Prophet teach us this? The Sahaba used to say this. It's not from the Sunnah shaking hands after Salah. It's not from the Sunnah shaking hands with each other after the Salah. It's not from the Sunnah that we put frames and writing things on the walls on the Musalla. It's not from the Sunnah. It's not the sunnah. I'm still talking about things that we see it here. We are not going to go too far. It's not the sunnah that you sit in a majlis al-ilm, in a circle of knowledge, stretching your legs in front of the imam, or the imam stretching his legs in front of the students. This is not the adab. And we see that Jibreel alayhi salam, when he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Adamin, فوضع يدي على فخذي وأسند ركبتي إلى ركبتي. How Jibreel said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, inform me about Islam, Iman, Islam. He said, stretching your legs. وما رؤيا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مادا رجلي بين الصحابة. When we sit, we have to learn how to sit. You have a problem with your knees? May Allah heal you. You can pull a chair and sit on it. But don't sit and stretch in your legs all the way. If the imam sneezes and put his head down like this, he will touch your socks. We have to learn the adab of sitting in the mosque and the adab when we are also receive the knowledge. It's not the sunnah that we go upstairs while downstairs is still empty. Neither it is the sunnah to lean in the back with no necessity while the front lines is still empty. The Prophet ﷺ said about the three people that came to his class. أَمَّا هَذَا فَقَدْ آوَى فَآوَى اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَأَمَّا هَذَا فَأَعْرَضَ فَأَعْرَضَ اللَّهُ عَنْهِ. So people have to learn how to sit in a class. Don't stretch your legs. And don't sit, you understand, like you're watching TV from a distance, relaxing. They're talking about something very important. They're discussing the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you're supposed to come and get closer. So the malaika can welcome you in their mercy, inshallah, by the will of Allah. It's not from the sunnah to repeat the salah, janazah, with somebody. And if anybody have evidence about it, I would love to learn it. I'm not claiming I'm a scholar. My limited of knowledge, when the Najashi, may Allah be pleased with him, die, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam makes salat al-ghaib, janazah prayer in absence person's behalf, because with nobody had prayer on Najashi. But we don't know that they repeated the salah in every masjid. So salat al-ghaib, making funeral prayer on somebody that nobody had prayer on him, to be done. And it's not the sunnah to be repeated again. Again, my dear respected brothers and sisters, this is my observation about things that we see it here. And this is a lot in our life. And like I said, kings, presidents, money, wives, husbands, children, cars, comes and goes. But Islam has to remain pure as is, has been revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the practice according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also according the understanding of the Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, especially the Khulafa al-Rashideen. Be concerned about the sunnah. There's no need to argue about it. Okay? Because arguing about things with no knowledge is not from the sunnah. So you go make your research first and don't think that deen is by logic. There is no room for logic in Islam. You submit. Islam means submission. Not for you to stay, why this and why that, and what's wrong if I did like this and that. Try to act upon the teaching. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the best understanding in the deen. Ameen. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. I did not copy this from any book, but alhamdulillah from some things that I observe and experience. Neither am I claiming to be the scholar of the town. So if anybody thinks that I said something wrong today or yesterday or tomorrow, like I always telling you, you come with your evidence. If you're right, I will give you the mic and you have let it to the people. Okay? A sister last week asked me a question. She said, is this a Salafi masjid? And I don't want to really bring it here, but to bring about misunderstanding and confusion and start the argument. Honestly, I don't know what a Salafi masjid look like. Does it have two doors or three doors? Does it have a dome or minaret? What do you mean a Salafi masjid? Did you ever see a Salafi masjid? And if the masjid is Salafi, is the people inside are Salafi? And if the people Salafi, is the imam is Salafi? I don't know, I said. I don't want to tell her, sister. I say, we talk about this later because this is bigger than to discuss it. Because this term itself is not been inherited from the Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, or al Khulafa al Rashideen. It's not been used in the early generations. I'm not saying the word Salaf. Yeah, word Salaf exists in Arabic. It's also before you. But when you say a Salafi masjid, is the Imam here himself, says that we here practice the Book of Allah, the authentic, not any hadith, authentic Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the understanding of the Sahaba. If you want to call this Salafi, you can call it Salafi. You want to call it, because as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, name yourself as Allah had named you. And Allah told us in Quran, "Millat abikum Ibrahim, huwa sammakum al-muslimin." This is the deen and the way of your father Ibrahim. He had named you, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muslims. And Allah always saying, "Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu." We don't see, "Oh, you Salafi people." And after this, if we say, yeah, we Salafi people, this, okay, the sister will come and sit to the class and sit to the sheikh. And after this, if he said no, she, you understand, is not going to come. So saying you are a Salafi is not going to make you Salafi. You can be claiming that you're Salafi, but you don't know even what is Salaf. And your akhlaq is not Salaf. Okay, but we know something. Alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnatu al-khulafa al-rashidin. We have the sunnah, we have Muslims, we have mu'min. The word Salaf, you understand, is a way to label certain people or a certain understanding. It's not a people. There is no something called people Salaf. This is not. And we don't want to use unity in the mosque. And somebody will get his baggage and start to walk away. Because brother, I told you, this Imam is not about the haqq, brother. He's not about the minhaj. Brother, if I'm not about the minhaj, it's okay. We have 5, 6, and inshallah by next year will be 10 masjid. You can go to the haqq masjid, or the Salafi masjid, or whatever masjid that you want. With symbol, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe in His book, we adhere to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We go by the understanding of the Sahaba, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnah. He said, hold to my sunnah and the sunnah of the right guided So we say we khalifas. So he made the way Salafi, I would say we are khalifas. He said, what's khalifas? This brother, I never heard. That mean we go by the Khulafa al-Rashideen, because the Prophet said in the hadith, wa sunnatu al-Khulafa al-Rashideen. Making up labels is dividing us. And I learned the experience and saw it in a different state and setting. Name will break a community and break marriages. Only because he's not saying, I'm Salafi. And the other will say, I'm Talafi. And the other one, he doesn't know what is what. All what you need, you get the magic word, now he will be in your mosque. Or that you give the magic word, and now he's running away from the mosque. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ He did not say a Salafiyun. He did not say the people. He said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً. Okay? So we need not to hang over words. We need to go to the reality of things. And we need to avoid things that bring about dissension among ourselves. May Allah guide us. May Allah make us from the people of Sunnah. Those people who hold fast to the teaching of Allah and the authentic Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and with the understanding of the Khulafa al-Rashideen and the Sahaba. Ameen. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
اعتدلوا راسو straight the line. Straighten the line is part of the establishment of the prayer. It is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shoulder to shoulder, foot to foot. Keep the line straight during the prayer until you finish. استووا اعتدلوا راسو استووا. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين
الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Salat al-Maghrib will be additional talk concerning the Sunnah, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Try to make some effort, inshallah, to be more educated about your deen. And if you already know it, it's not going to harm you to sit in the mosque for 45 minutes. Jazakumullah khair.
Thank you. Good to keep you here for the spring. You looking good.
Yeah.
I am. I'm going to be thankful.